right, on Mars TV now, the issue of the day is a serious one, and it is that of fire.
Nick, fire and boats don't really mix, and you hope to never have a blaze on board your boat, but if it does happen, it pays to be prepared.
The Rene Del Mar didn't stand a chance. Within minutes, the cabin cruiser was engulfed in a ball of flames.
Fire on board a boat is one of the most frightening and potentially destructive events that can happen at sea. Powerboats particularly carry big fuel loads, and once alight can be very hard to put out. For boats under 8 metres, the legal requirement is one kilo dry powder extinguisher. Most boats have one, but when was the last time you had a look at yours?
Fire extinguishers sometimes taken for granted. As with most safety gear, you have it on board and that's it, you're conforming with the law. So it's really important that you do check your fire extinguisher on a regular basis, give it a bit of a tap with a rubber mallet or a block of wood, not too hard of course, just to loosen up that powder and make sure that it can be used and ready for action. Might not even be your boat on fire, it might be somebody else's.
At a recent Mast Open Day, the Longford Fire Brigade demonstrated the effectiveness of the standard 1 kilo extinguisher and its bigger 2 kilo and 9 kilo brothers.
See this now, he's blown the fuel out of the container and onto the ground, and it's actually reignited on the ground as well.
The 1 kilo was okay, but nowhere near as effective as the bigger extinguishers.
Much, much better. You see the difference. That's the extinguisher that you want to use.
I'd be thinking of either a 2 kilo or two 1 kilo extinguishers and storing them obviously on different parts of the boat, but certainly don't store them next to your fire ignition sites, which would be your fuel or your electrical system.
Apart from being a legal requirement, if you haven't got your extinguisher on your boat and you end up with a fuel fire or any other reason for a fire to start on the boat, you've got no control over that. Once the boat's on fire, the only option for you to do is get out of that boat and get into the water. And sometimes that could be a very serious option.
So next time you're in the boat, take the time to check your fire extinguisher. Remember, the pounding action can cause the powder to set like a rock if you don't give it a shake and a tap annually. Check the gauge is showing correct pressure. And most importantly, is the thing somewhere where you can get at it quickly should the need arise. For more information, the Mast website has a detailed page on how to guard against fire. Look for it under the general safety heading. And thanks for watching Mast TV.